Welcome to Doggo.jl, your home for wholesome Julia tutorials. Like the while loop, the for loop is another example of a repeated evaluation control flow tool. But unlike the while loop, the for loop doesn't use any conditional statements. With the for loop, you, as the programmer, tell your computer how many times you want it to repeat a task or set of tasks. Let's take a look at an example. I'm in VS Code, and I've already created a new .jl file. I've also launched the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. For the next few chapters, I'm going to dock my REPL next to my editor. You can move the Julia REPL by clicking and dragging the Julia REPL tab, and then dropping it somewhere else in the user interface when an available space is highlighted. To create a for loop, use the keywords for and end. Now, before hitting Shift Enter, let's talk about this code. In Julia, 1:10 is called the range object. The first number is the starting number in the range, and the second number is the ending number in the range. The range includes both the starting number and the ending number. What's implied in the syntax is that the step size in between the first number and the second number is positive 1. In other words, this syntax means the range of integers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. By convention, the lowercase letter I is used for the variable name for the range object. But you can use any name that you like. Also, notice that we did not declare this variable name before creating the for loop. That's because this variable named lowercase I exists only in this for loop. In other words, it's created by the for loop, used by the for loop, and then discarded, so it ceases to exist once the for loop has ended. In between the range object and the keyword end is the task or set of tasks that you want your computer to repeat. Now hit Shift Enter to see what happens. In the REPL, you'll see the integers 1 through 10, inclusive. This is the same output that you got when using a while loop, but the for loop was able to do it using less code. In addition, the for loop only repeats a task or set of tasks for the number of times in the range, so there's no risk of an infinite loop. On the flip side, the for loop is merely doing what it's told to do. There's no logical thinking involved, since there are no conditional statements. So those are the main differences between a for loop and a while loop. The for loop is a very efficient form of automation that you can use if you know in advance how many times you want your computer to repeat a task. The while loop is not as efficient as the for loop, but the while loop is a more sophisticated form of automation that allows your computer to decide on its own when to stop performing a task based on a certain condition. The while loop is a good choice if you don't know in advance how many times you need your computer to repeat a task. One of the keys to using the for loop is understanding how the range object works. So let's take a look at a couple more examples. Here, I'm copying and pasting the code by using Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V. In this example, the range object has three numbers separated by colons. Like in the first example, The first number is the starting number in the range, inclusive. The last number is the ending number in the range, inclusive. The number in between is the step size. So 0:5:50 means the integers 0, 5, 10, etc., and ending with 40, 45, and 50. This is optional, but before hitting Shift Enter, I'm going to clear my REPL window by clicking on the REPL tab and then using Control L. Using Control L in the REPL just clears the display. It doesn't clear anything from memory. Okay, now back in the editor, you can hit Shift Enter. In the REPL, you'll see the integers 0 to 50 using a step size of positive 5. Now the step size doesn't need to be a positive number. In Julia, you can use a negative number for the step size. Let's take a look at that example next. Again, you can copy and paste this code. When using a negative step size, be sure that the starting number in the range is larger than the ending number in the range. Like before, I'm going to clear the REPL window by using Control L. And then hit Shift Enter in the editor. This time in the REPL, you'll see the integers from 1 to 10 in descending order. Pretty cool, right? So that's the basics of using a for loop by using a range object. In the next chapter, you'll learn how to use a for loop to loop over a collection without using a range object.